Hey everybody, welcome back to UltraChenTV. I'm James Chen. You're watching Learn to Fight, where I talk about how my mindset is playing and everything like that. And last week, I think the number one thing that I learned was that lack of sleep plus no food equals bad, bad, bad. The other thing that's bad is constant playing, and also when I get salty, I really just start shutting down. My brain starts shutting down. I have this weird spiral when I start playing badly. It's almost like I purposely keep playing badly because it just like it feeds into itself. That's just, I mean, that's a factor of sadness and depression in people. Like people who exhibit signs of, you know, depression and stuff like that have that pattern that when failure kind of happens, when you start feeling down about yourself, you kind of want to keep that trend going subconsciously a little bit. I'm not saying I'm losing on purpose. It's just that you stop paying attention as much. So trying to fix a lot of those things, trying to keep more of a positive outlook while I'm playing these games. I had lunch properly. I'm now drinking my water. And I'll answer some questions from the chat right now. First one, Eli Hendrix asks, James, how many cats do I have? I have two cats. Jasmine and Nathan, they are the most adorable kitties in the world. Let me see if I can grab some photos of them, actually, because they are... I'm just totally going to do this. I'm totally doing this right now. I'm totally doing this, and I'm going to show my cats on stream. Come on. Doing this weird thing here. I'm totally gonna do this. I'm totally doing this because I'm one of those people and I'm obsessed with it. So, I mean, look, I want to talk about depression a lot too, not because I'm like, oh, woe is me, sadness, whatever like that. But honestly, the reason why it's important for me to talk about depression, to acknowledge that it's a thing, and I've been talking about this to some friends recently too, is that depression, sadness, that kind of mentality is a thing that is looked so down upon and it's frowned upon. It's like whenever you see someone who's sad, your reaction is, why don't you just be happy? Hey, things are so much worse for all these other people. Like, look at all these starving kids in Africa or something like that. And you know, that's the tough part, is when you're a sad and depressed kind of person, you are told that there's something wrong with you for being depressed. Now, when you're depressed, it's usually just a chemical imbalance or it's just a condition. It's genetic. My mom is like this a lot, and so that's where I got it from. You know, there's a lot of factors to it, and you know, telling somebody, why can't you just be happy? Look at the bright side of things, makes people feel worse. By actually talking about it, by knowing other people who go through this, who, if you talk about it openly, like depression is just a thing, like it's just a condition, right? Like, oh, hey, you know, like David, like he's like, he has that hand condition, right? So I'm just like, well, sometimes I get depressed sometimes. If you start talking about it from that standpoint, it becomes a normal thing. It becomes a thing that everybody goes through, and so you don't feel like there's something wrong with you anymore, because the number one thing to help people with depression is to let them know there's nothing wrong with being depressed. It's something that happens, and it happens to a lot of people. So help them through it, talk them through it, you know, be supportive of them, listen to their problems and stuff, and don't trivialize their feelings. You know, that's just the way it comes down to. So I've made a vow to myself that I was going to talk about it a lot more, because that's something that I preach, so that I want to uphold that. If I'm telling people that depression should be a topic that people talk about more, I feel like then we should talk about it more. So, but yeah, that's the concept right there. God, this cat is adorable. Jesus, this cat is the most adorable thing. Like, tell me that you do not think that this is the most adorable cat. Like, look at this thing. Look at this booger. Look at this goober here. This is Nathan. This is Nathan right here. This is my boy Nathan. Look at this guy. This guy is really, this guy is just like, the most adorable thing ever. Look at this. Look at his face. He's like, hey, James, what's up? What's up? What's up? I actually want to see if I can make some emotes out of my cats. I need to find some good ones. There's one great picture of my cat that I really wanted to do, but I just haven't had a chance to put it up yet. Here we go. Look at this guy. Look at him with his belly rubs. This guy likes belly rubs, dude. This guy likes belly rubs. So, look at this guy. Look at this guy. This is Nathan, by the way. My ex named him after Nathan Drake, of course, of Uncharted. I wanted to name him Blues because his eyes were blue. And that way my other cat's name is Jasmine. I'd have Jazz and Blues, which are both Transformers, which are both music references. But, you know, I didn't get that, so... why don't I stream with Nathan? Because I'm in the stream. This is the studio space. And unfortunately, the studio space has too many wires and everything like that, and the cats do not have access to this space. So I can't actually stream with the cats down here, unfortunately. I would love to, because, yeah, for sure, it would be awesome to be able to stream with them running around. Which is why I actually want to get a second setup where I can actually start streaming from upstairs, so that I can actually stream with the cats around. I'm sorry, I'm totally doing this cat thing here. I'm totally turning into the... I'm being cat lady right now. I'm being crazy cat lady right now. If you're in shape, you can still be crazy. That is definitely for sure true. Where's some good pictures of Jazzy? It's tough to take good pictures of Jasmine, honestly, because she's a black cat, and so it's hard to see her in a lot of the pictures. But here's a great picture. There she is. This was me playing Guilty Gear on the ground, and when I play fighting games upstairs, like, she would just come and sit next to me, and she would stare at me. She would sleep on my foot, and she would just sit there and watch me play. So. UID, honestly, renewing subscriptions is nice, because it's an ongoing thing. Of course, Twitch takes part of that, but the benefit to that is I can make more emotes, which is always cool to do. Donations go all directly to me, but they're a one-time thing. Honestly, I don't make a preference. Because there's benefits to both. I would love making more emotes for everybody, and not just having... You know, like, give me all the money. Like, if you're subscribing to me, then that means I can also return some of the benefits to you guys. So, all right. Sorry. Slow and steady is like, hey, can you play some matches, please? Okay, let's go ahead and do that. No more cats. No more cats for now. No more cats. I had a nice break. Drink some water. Let's play some online matches. Yep, minus the food stealing, because they do that. All right, let's get back to this. Let's get back to some of these online matches here. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's the joystick that I'm using right now. Got Guilty Gear buttons. In fact, I have more buttons I need to put on there. I got three extra buttons that I need to stick on here to fully buttonize it. Like, originally I did it so it was just the five buttons that you use in Guilty Gear, but I really want to add some more buttons to it, so I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna add three more buttons. I have a Johnny button. That's the thing, is that when Sign came out and these buttons were available, there was no Johnny. So I got these five, and then when Johnny came out, I was like, all right, I have to buy Johnny. But then if I buy Johnny, now I have six buttons on there, and that doesn't make any sense for Guilty Gear, so I've got to fill out all the buttons. I got to do all the buttons, so I ended up with all the buttons. could you, at some point down the line, do a little explanation on Cammy's dive kicks and the positioning of them? I can't seem to find the right place on screen to do them and make them work. thank you, Slow and Steady. Normally, I'm very quiet and I'm salty on stream, but I'm really trying to change things up right now. I'm really, really trying to change things up. Myself personally, and just through a lot of different things, really trying to trying to have more fun. That's basically all it is, so. But before I get the match, basically what you want to do with dive kicks, honestly, is aim for that. Aim for the shins right there. Because once you aim for the shins, if you hit them, you can combo into crouching light kick into dive kick. And if they block it, you have an advantage. You're actually in an advantage situation, right? So let's set her to all guard and let's regard recovery actions. Let's see if that one's the right one already. Yes, it is. So basically, if I can aim for the shins like that, you see how like I can trade. I'm not negative, and see, if I do it just right, I actually get the advantage. I beat her jab. Right? So that's what you're trying to aim for. So I'm doing it largely by sight now, because what I've learned is that this range here where I want to dash and surprise them. So a few weeks ago, I made it a point that I wanted to dash up more and be aggressive in this situation, dash up like this. And so I started doing this, but people would blow up my dash. Then I fought another Cammy that would dash at me a lot, so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna look for her dash and blow her up when she dashes at me. Instead of dashing, she would jump and dive kick. And I realized this dash and this jump dive kick, that's the mix-up right there. That's the mix-up of getting in. And at that one distance where you dash and can crouching medium punch them, is the same distance that if you jump and heavy kick dive kick, it hits them in the shin. It's perfect. It's like a great distance. So you'll really only use the light and medium kick ones if you see them walk forward and you can adjust in time. But otherwise, at that distance, dash or jump dive kick, I feel like is such a good mix up. Oh boy. Oh boy. I don't know if I'm gonna play Colleen on stream tomorrow. Because tomorrow is going to be ESL, so I'm actually going to be streaming live from the studio tomorrow. So I'm not going to be able to stream tomorrow afternoon, but like I said, at night on Tuesday, maybe we'll all just load her up and mess with her and see what happens. But Guile is a tough one. Ow! And he's going to backfist me in the face. And there's a little bit of lag. Okay, I figured he wanted to chase me. Okay, wasn't ready for jump. Oh my god. What is going on? I think he's feeling it too, which is why he's going desperation crouch roundhouse. Oh my god, just flash kick. I thought that was gonna be a hit. Okay, we're all confused here. Oh, that's gonna be a problem. I didn't mean to super and I did the wrong one. Yeah, you know what? We're both confused as all hell right now. We have no idea what's going on. We have no idea what's going on. Ow! You backfisted me again. Ooh, you are a sweepy guy. I have no idea what's going on. Final round. Fight. Actually, if I just let that drill hit, it probably would have stunned him. Yeah, it's a nice Ajada. Sorry. Sometimes the Chinese just comes out like that. I think I'm double tapping because in Street Fighter V, it's better to double tap than it is to plink. Plinking is not useful. Double tapping is useful in this game. But I'm sorry, I just dropped you down to super gold and I'm gonna run on you. But you know that that was a pretty loud. Yeah, see, I didn't even have to do it. He just left himself. He was like, man, fuck this netcode. Oh my god. Yeah, nope. Totally understood. Totally understood. Double tapping. Did you just call it Martian cursing? Are you really calling Asian languages Martian language, James? I'm sad. God. Well, actually, you know what? It kind of makes sense. Actually, James the Powerhead, I think you're onto something here, right? Because who was in the Martian? Matt Damon. Who's in the Great Wall? Matt Damon. Everything makes sense. Everything makes sense now. You are absolutely right that Chinese is probably came from Mars. It all makes sense. Matt Damon traveled to Mars. He learned Chinese. He brought it back and taught it to China while he killed the monsters at the Great Wall. It all makes sense now. I don't speak great Mandarin. I speak a little bit of Mandarin. 我会说一点。 但是我的 pronunciation 不大好，每个人跟我说我说中文的时候，他们会听到很厉害一个 English accent. Thanks, Matt Damon. All right. Now, I'm wondering if Slow and Steady actually speaks Chinese, or if it's just, do you speak Chinese as well, Eli Hendricks? Yeah, I mean, 我长大的时候，我爸爸和妈妈会每次用国语跟我们说话，所以我会听得懂一点，也是我听得很多，我就会练习一点。 但是我就是不知道很多字，不知道怎么说很多字，也是我的 pronunciation 不大好。像 pronunciation 我不知道怎么用英文说，也是，you know Chinese people, I feel like they don't have a word for the word message. Like listen to Chinese people, and every time they tell people to leave like a voice message, they always go, hey, 可不可以留我一个 message? 给我留一个 message. It's like they never actually, there's like no Chinese word for message or something like that, so. It is a very melodic sounding language. In fact, they say a lot of people who speak Chinese have very good pitch. They have perfect pitch because it's a very tonal language. And I saw her try to jump earlier, so I was actually ready for that's punishable, but I didn't punish it properly. Oh, sweeps! Okay, Buttonsy Laura. What in the world is going on? Ooh, I missed the standing light kick and I threw. Tom Cruise is the Last Samurai. Emma Stone won an Oscar yesterday. Not for Aloha, but in Aloha she was half Asian. Cause that totally makes sense. Because she looks nothing, she might have been a quarter Asian, but still, she doesn't look anything Asian. You want to get out of the corner. I guess you don't want to get out of the corner. That sucked. Ooh, just kick her in the face! The TV's in Esperanto. Your wife speaks Mandarin, Taiwanese, and Tagalog. Ah, nice. Okay, good stuff. All I know in Tagalog is sige. That's the only thing I know, which means like, okay, that's all I know is sige. And also, there's something about like, I want to go down the elevator that's kind of like ba 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 or something like that, but I don't remember what it is. and the Laura ran. Was it laggy for them? Because that's the thing. It's like whenever I see someone run after one game like that, I'm always like, do they hate Cammy or was it laggy for them? Because the lag is always can be one-sided, which sucks. So sometimes I can sit here and play and be like, he ran because he's all salty. Rah! But it might have just been that his lag sucked on his side. So, dude, don't get me started, Guns Ablaze. Any of you who follow me, who are friends with me on Facebook, I don't know if anybody here is friends with me on Facebook, but any one of you guys there knows how much that bothers me. Like, I talk about it on Facebook all the time. I actually don't talk about it that much on Twitter, but on Facebook all the time. So back to dive kicks, the range. This is the range right here. After standing medium kick, tip of standing medium kick is the perfect range for dash into buttons, or tip of medium kick is great for roundhouse dive kick if you can do it at the right timing, see? So this you can use as a measuring stick here. Even if it misses, that's a good range right there. So if it touches them or if it misses them, that's like the good range for the dive kick or the forward dash mix up. That's how you use the roundhouse dive kick. The weird thing was that in Street Fighter 4, because you could dive kick onto people's head and it really didn't matter, I always used the medium kick button. So when I first played this game, I would always use the medium kick dive kick. And the problem is at that range, it missed a lot and I would get myself killed. And I was like, the dive kick can't hit anybody. But I learned that it's the heavy dive kick that you want to use at this range. So basically at this range, learn to use the heavy dive kick. Now, obviously it still is hard against three frame jabs to be in a plus position, but it is possible there. But that's for heavy kick dive kick. I need to talk about EX dive kick a little bit, because EX dive kick is a completely different beast. It's a completely, oh my God, Korean barbecue is the best. Korean barbecue is the best. So EX dive kick, if you're at this range right here, it's usually too high. It hits them high up. See, I got punished. I actually got punished for that because EX dive kick was really nerfed in season 2. So EX dive kick is a dangerous move to use at that range, unless you can do it as low as humanly possible, which obviously I cannot because I'm a scrub. If you can do it as low as possible, it can do all the same things as the roundhouse dive kick, but it's still risky. It's still risky. Now, EX dive kick is better to be used a little bit further distance than the roundhouse dive kick, in my opinion. If you can do it super low to the ground and hit them on the shins, it's good, but remember, it's much more negative in this version. Before, I used to use it to dive kick on top of people's head. You can still see I do that, like after throw techs. And things like that. It's just a habit, and then I get myself killed for it, and it's just, I'm trying to unlearn that. I do allow links in chats, so feel free to post whatever you want, Daryl. Get good, yep. How to win more consistently in gold rank. Okay, I'll talk to you in just a little bit after I fight. Daryl, you go pull! Patience. I don't care about the poison. I don't care about the Nishikyu. Well, I will just get hit by the Nishikyu. Oops. Oh, it went over my head. I'm so lucky. Okay, patience. Patience. Don't try to get in on him when I don't need to. Let him back off. It's okay. Ay-ya-ya! Nice throw. Oh, nice escape. I love it. Jesus. Okay, see, more patience. I didn't keep trying to get in. I didn't let him bait me into trying to get in. I got in when I got in, and that worked good. I back medium punch for once in my life, and it didn't work. This is my life, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my god. Oh, that sleeves. I'm gonna die, except he dropped his combo, except that's not punishable, so I'm gonna die anyway. Oops. Why did I do EX? Ah, I should've just super. Oh, that was far. This character causes me so much confusion. Oh my god! I'm still okay. I did crouching medium punch and he threw me right- Okay, so it's when Fong starts doing stuff like that that I have problems fighting. When he starts going nuts, I don't know, like, exactly what his offense is, and I have a lot of trouble fighting that. Gotta learn how to deal with that kind of offense there. When he's Fong starts going nuts like that. But he definitely has a read that I'm not good at stopping jumps at up close. I should use back medium punch more for sure. Oops, I can't uppercut in the middle of that. What the hell? Ah, it doesn't reach high enough because he jumps so high. Interesting. Okay. Oh, he stayed in the front. What in the world just happened? Again! Nice jabs to get out of the way. Ow! That reached so far! Holy crap! I didn't think that was gonna reach that far. Nice escape. God, I'm punching, but I'm just not catching him in time. God, I get hit by that every single time. Patience, just trying to play so much more patient. Gotta play patient. What the hell? God dang it, that stupid sleeve! Ooh, man, I can't deal with that mix-up once he gets in. It's when Fong gets close in that I actually die. I can't fight him when he does that because I feel like every button he pushes is positive. Like if he does that little coward crouch kick, or if he does crouching medium kick, he's positive. If he does the knees, he's positive, so... Ugh, I have so much trouble in that fight. I don't know that fight. It's okay. Yeah, I didn't want a V reversal because I wanted to save my meter for the V trigger. But I probably should just do it. Because I never really got a chance to activate the V trigger anyway. I'm becoming a little over reliant on landing V trigger for damage. Back to dive kicks here. So if you want an EX dive kick, it's usually better to do it from this range over here right away. See how that actually catches at the shin. So be a little further away. At this range right here, terrible place to use dive kick because you can get punished. But further away, it actually works better instant, which is weird because before, you know, that's what I should learn to do. I should do the old style instant tiger knee dive kick. Like that, because that actually hits at the shins a lot easier. It's easier to aim at the shins, and it has a lower height restriction. So that's something I should learn to do. Because you can't do that with the regular dive kick. It's hard because the height restriction is so much higher. But with the EX one, the height restriction is lower, so I can actually aim at the shins a little better. So there you go, actually. So the old Tiger Knee code was half circle back, forward flip, two kicks. That's how you did it before, and that did it at the lowest height possible. So at the same ranges that the heavy kick one works, the same ranges at which the heavy kick one works, it looks like Tiger Knee EX dive kick works as well. So I gotta learn to implement that. That makes it so that I can do a much faster to the ground and become such a better tool. Maybe this is why my EX dive kicks are so bad, because I've always been doing them like this and ending up too high. Like so. See, when I do it like this, even though I'm blocking, I'm negative. Like, I can't do anything. But if I actually learn to tiger knee it, basically, then I can be in a much better position and save it that way. So, yeah, that's actually a good call. I probably should have just EXDP in the middle of there. Ugh, man. But basically tiger kneeing a move, because the original tiger knee move was down towards forward, up forward, and kick. So you actually had to go to forward flip to do the move. And so a lot of people call it tiger kneeing it because that's how you did like air hyper viper beam. That's how you do a lot of different commands, like air commands immediately off the floor, because you would basically use a tiger knee motion. Of course, now it's just like completely obfuscated from its original meaning, like every other fighting game term on the planet.
For those who I wish to protect, I will fight you.
Round one. Fight.
Okay, I'll get to you, Showbiz. Whoops. Ooh, cute. Boy, you're always hitting a button there, frame trap, getting frame trap. Ooh, that was too close. Oh, don't you try to overhead me. A lot of people don't know that goes behind, so you just get away with that a lot. You get away with a lot more than you should. Ow! Nice punish. You knew how to punish that. And I did not cross you up? Wow. Balrog's overhead is unsafe. I did not punish it in time. I punished it with the wrong move. The first hit of that is low. Oh my god! Help! Alright, I'm just taking the damage now. I'm taking the damage now, because I get damage and I get a setup off of this. So let's go. Woo! Alright, so there we go. Got my setup off of that, and there was that meaty standing light kick. I did screw up a little bit, and I didn't confirm my combo and went for the throw, and I missed the throw, and I was still able to punch him in time. But anyways, I ended up taking it anyway. So all overheads are minus six, basically. But Showbiz, please give me your questions again once I'm done with this match, and I will talk about it a little bit. Yeah, he always gets frame trapped there. Okay, finally blocking. Scared. Yeah! Cammy can rush down too. Cammy's cheap and broken as well. Ah, super! Is it gonna kill? No. Oh! Sorry, Ibarra, but I'm gonna have to pop off for a second here with the double perfect. That dirty, cheap Cammy. Broken ass character. The hell, man? Broken ass character. What the hell is wrong with this stupid character? Jeez. Jeez, why do I have to use such a broken-ass character, dude? God, what a cheap, cheap character. What a broken-ass character. Oh, man. You do not have to memorize all the frame data of your character, Vanilla Rune. And I've talked about that before. Actually, go to youtube.com/UltraChenTV and look up... First Attack 5.3, where I talk all about frame data. It's not necessarily knowing all of the frame data, it's just categorizing your moves. There are moves that are gonna be your turn, there are moves that are gonna be their turn, there are moves that are gonna be unsafe, there are moves that are like comboable, etc., etc. So if you can go to youtube.com/UltraChenTV, look up First Attack 5.3. That is the frame data episode, and I talk all about frame data, how to interpret frame data, how to read frame data, what all the numbers mean, and how to get the most out of that information. So definitely check that out if you can. So that has a lot of information, please. So Showbiz asks, how do I train myself to win more consistently or make an effective adjustment with my gameplay on the fly? It currently feels like I'm gonna be stuck in gold forever with 4750 LP. Okay. Showbiz, I've definitely talked about this during our Guilty Gear sessions. The way that you make adjustments on the fly is that you really have to start evaluating the opponent and what it is that they want to do. If you notice the way that I play this, and you know, when I play, what I'm trying to think at the time. So the first perfect I got on this Balrog, I did a throw loop, and then I went for something else. So I felt like the second time I was about to get a perfect on him, I threw him three times in a row because last time I did two and stopped. But I used the information from the previous game to help in this game. And then you notice when I play against people, I'm like, okay, this is a defensive person. Oh, this person likes to hit buttons. Oh, this person is aggressive. So like the Ryu player, I noticed he would throw two fireballs, dance around, dash forward at me. So I was able to beat him because I recognized that pattern. He was using the fireballs as a harassment tool to get me to stop hitting buttons so he could dash at me. And once I started figuring that out, I would let him hang himself. I would let him do that, and then when he dashed forward, I'd fierce into V-trigger into combo, right? So that's the kind of thing. Cammy and Johnny James the tear whore, seriously. But that's basically what it is. And you know, it's kind of not fair. I mean, it is. Yeah, use your brain, but like in a less you know, pedantic kind of way, and I don't think that that's what Predator Batman is trying to say. I don't think he's trying to be mean about it or anything like that, but it can, you know, you hear that and you're like, but I am using my, like, honestly, like, just make sure that you understand that the person that you are fighting against, the other person on the other side, is a human being who has patterns, thoughts, reactions, and the same problems that you run into. They're just probably better at controlling it. So if you just can figure out what it is that they want to do and what their thought process is, and can guide the way that they think. Last week I talked about telling stories, telling your opponent's stories, and trying to read your opponent's story, and always trying to figure out the spoiler. Actually, I didn't say that last week, but I love that. I love that, actually. That's really good. So your goal, basically, is you're always trying to tell a false story. You're M. Night Shyamalan, okay? When you're playing fighting games, you're trying to tell them a story, but there's always a twist. There's always a twist that you can catch them off guard. Your job is to read and watch the other person's story, but keep trying to ruin the movie for yourself by guessing the twist. You're always trying to guess the twist in the story. And if you can guess the twist, when the twist happens, you're already ready for it. That's basically the best way to play. It's really about knowing and playing against the other person that's on the other side. That they have to be someone that you have to process the fact that they are a human being, and they are there, and they are ready to play, and they can be molded, and you can find these patterns and stuff like that. So the reason why I do these sessions, the reason why, is because I hope when I don't get salty, because when I do get salty, I grow silent, and you notice that I play worse too, because I get salty. But like, when I'm thinking properly, and I'm evaluating my opponent, and I'm talking about the opponent, I actually get much better. And the way what I do is I'm always like, okay, this is an aggressive person. Oh, okay, he teched a throw in this situation, which means he's looking for throws, so that means I can set up a shimmy. Oh, this person's not touching a lot of buttons. Oh, this Balrog kept getting hit by standing strong, low strong, so I had the counter hit combo ready to go, etc., etc. These are things that you have to do when you play the game, is really understand how to read the opponent. And if you're only playing by yourself, like, I know Cammy does this, so like here, for example, let me show you this right here. Spike, don't ruin everything, okay? Because some of those are really super, super good. Stop it, Spike. Stop ruining all the M. Night Shyamalan movies, okay? Okay. But basically, like, for example, was it you, or there was another Karen out there that was actually talking about, you know, how do I time the dive kicks properly? How do I learn to use the dive kicks correctly? And so what I told you is that standing medium kick is a good range right here for a roundhouse dive kick, right? Because I can actually hit him in the shins. And if I do that, whoops, and if I do that, Jesus, hang on a second, let me do something really quick. Just turn this off, just so I don't have to deal with this. So if I actually hit him with it properly, I'm plus, right? Or I'm even, which is always better than being negative. So if I do this, whoops. Jeez, I'm hitting it too fast. I'm just doing it before I actually get to the height restriction. So I can be plus, right? So at tip of standing roundhouse, I can be plus in that situation. But here's the thing, right? If you're the Cammy player and you're like, oh, okay, well, I really want to get in by dive kick. So I'm going to walk up, hit him with standing medium kick, and dive kick, right? The problem with that is that you're now playing the one player game. You're like, hey, I just want to walk up, get him to block this so I can dive kick and be plus. Woo! The problem is you did not include what the Karen player is doing or thinking or what she's doing. Is she very offensive? If she's aggressive and she dashes a lot and she likes to poke a lot of buttons, then don't even bother with that. Just keep messing her up with standing medium kicks and try to intercept dashes with crouching medium punches. Like, these are your two buttons to use when they start going crazy on offense. If they're very defensive and they don't touch a lot of buttons, then this becomes a great tactic because they're not hitting anything. But that's the time you want to use it, because if they're playing defensive and they're being really good at keeping you out, then you need to find a way to get in. So that's when you start applying this tactic. If you just decide to do it regardless of how your opponent plays, that's not going to help you at all, right? That's going to be a problem. So what you really, really want to do is just make sure that you are always basing your moves, your offense, on what you think the opponent is going to do. That's the number one key thing. That's the number one key thing. Oh God, Spike, please don't even remind me that Shyamalan did a version of that movie. Oh, the Avatar. I really wish someone would remake that into a film, but since the first one bombed so much, I really doubt anyone's gonna ever do that. But and by the way, just as a shameless plug for my friend, if you're fans of The Legend of Korra, new sequels have been created in comic book form. You can buy it on Amazon right now. And it's written by one of the original co-writers of the Avatar series. But the entire comic was drawn by one of my friends. So definitely check that out. And Amazon.com, check out The Legend of Korra sequel comics. With Ken, you just take the joystick and like smash it on your face. And then you'll like run and like do a bunch of stuff. No, I'm just kidding. I can't. I can't be mean to Ken players like that. I don't know Ken very well. But I do know that Ken is about getting the opponent scared. That is largely what Ken is about, is getting them scared to touch buttons and stuff like that. It is really about confusing them and getting them scared. And he has the most Dudley game. He has the most Dudley game out of everybody from Street Fighter 4, because now his thunder kick is so scary. His thunder kick is really, really scary. Ryu? Holy crap! You know what? When Daigo Umehara on Twitter and in social media says, you know what? I can't make Ryu work by myself. I need the help of other people. Let's share tactics. And now Daigo is actually trying to get help from other people on how to play Ryu. You know Ryu has a problem in this game, okay? Ryu is gonna be tough. He's gonna be really, 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 really tough. Do you think they'll touch Karen in this upcoming balance patch? Dude, Karen is the ultimate Homer going into the bush character right now. Karen is super good. You see what Punk is doing to people. Nobody talks about her. Nobody has her in their top five except for a few people, right? Everyone's always talking about Cammy, Yuri, and Balrog, Laura, and Guile. And even Cammy is kind of like hiding a little bit in the corner. But honestly, Karen is just like sitting off to the side going, oh. You know, I mean, because she's just chilling over there. So I don't know if they're going to nerf her or not, to be honest with you. I feel like she's actually going to stay relatively untouched, which is really, really scary. My Ryu advice is throw controller. My Ryu advice, honestly, is... I really wish I had some good Ryu advice. I really actually don't know what to do with him too. What is QCB? QCB is quarter circle back. That's this motion, you know, to do Cammy's dive kick. That's quarter circle back. Quarter circle back is what that is. So, just like QCF is quarter circle forward, which is the drill command. DP is uppercut. There's also anime notation, which basically you look at your number pad, and quarter circle back becomes 214. Quarter circle forward is 236, DP is 623. So there's some people who prefer that notation. There's all sorts of different kinds of notations and stuff. So, but man, Ryu, because they nerfed his two main things, which is crouching medium kick and standing light kick and standing medium punch. Like, they nerfed all three of his best buttons. I don't know if crouching medium kick got nerfed, but I know standing light kick did. And I know standing medium punch did, and those are like his two best ground buttons, and he doesn't really have that much anymore. I'm not sure. I really wish I had better things. Oh, so you're from Korea and they actually do use the number pad notation. Okay, well there you go. But Showbiz, I hope that made sense, the stuff that I was talking about telling stories and learning to figure out other stories and stuff like that. So, Avatar the Search. Lionheart Rar, I did not see that. I don't know what Lionheart the Search is. Oh, okay. It's 5 o'clock actually too, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play one more match, and I'll once again take a break because I'm trying to get myself to do that. Drink some water, be hydrated, and try to make sure that I do not increase the salt levels or give people reason to post some Chen rages in the chat. So, secret top tier characters in Street Fighter V, Rashid. Rashid is one of them. Although there's a lot of people out there who do know that Rashid is super good, but Rashid is definitely kind of in the weeds in there. Maybe Zangief. The way Itazan makes him play, but I'm not sure. Like, I'm not sold on Zangief yet. I feel like there's something about Zangief that I don't know yet or something like that. But yeah, I kind of agree with Budafuka. Karin and Ibuki are both really good. Dark Souls comeback I want to do, but I gotta figure out a way to get Joe out here. But if he's gonna be stuck at E-League for like 2 months, I don't know if I'm gonna get him out here anytime soon. But I will definitely do something of getting Joe back here for a few days so that we can do long term. Okay, see, this Ryu's moving forward, right? You saw him walk forward at the beginning of the round, now he jumped at me. Aggressive Ryu. I know this is an aggressive Ryu, so I'm gonna play defense because I have no reason to play aggressive against him because he's coming in, and that was supposed to be an uppercut, but I just messed up. Oh, he doesn't know about the nerf. Juke. Oh, he hit me and I lost my V-trigger off of that. Oh, I'm gonna take big amount of damage. Oh, he went for a reset? That was not what he wanted to do at all. He probably wanted an EX fireball. Accidentally went to forward flip. Second, I'll answer some questions in a second after I. Ooh! See, the Ryu always. This Ryu wants to go forward a lot, so I don't have to do anything. I'm not trying to get in. I'm not doing the dashing thing that much. I'm just letting him do it, and wow, I took the throw! Dude, drink water, kids! You see how much drinking water helps? Drink your water! Drink your water! Drink your water, ladies and gentlemen! I'm taking throws and I'm doing all sorts of things right now that I've never done before. Water! Water is the key! Water is the key! Stay hydrated, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, man. Nakali is a great answer for secret top tier characters. Nakali. Yes, for sure. Oh, nice empty jump and a sweep. See, now he's playing a little more defensive. He's not coming forward as much. So I'm going to be a little more aggressive now. So now that was so unfortunate for him. Now the dive kicks are coming out from me. Oh, beautiful back throw. But you get nothing off of that because you're Ryu and that sucks. Okay, empty jump into button beats me up so bad. Oops. Nice uppercut. God, I'm feeling myself today. Okay. No, I got it. You know what? This is bad. Don't pop off before a match ends. Do not pop off. I'm losing the next two rounds, guaranteed. Guaranteed I'm losing the next two rounds because I'm starting to feel myself too much. I'm falling into the Mike Ross! I'm falling into the Mike Ross! You can't become Mike Ross! Nobody wants to become Mike Ross! How we go on a break, ladies and gentlemen. That is how you go to a break right now. So I'm gonna take a quick break. When I come back, we'll have some more educational discourse about how to play Street Fighter V. Esteban 10001, was that Esteban? I don't think that's actually him. I don't think that was actually him. Shout outs to the subscription to Batij. Appreciate it very much. Ooh. We've got ourselves a clip here. I have to open this so that I can save that for later and post it up onto post it up later. Okay. Dude, it's so funny because like I actually don't drink a lot of water. Even at tournaments, at anything, I'm just drinking soda and Coke all day. Dude, like, whoever it was last week who told me to stay hydrated, and whoever, when I went on the first break, said, James, go get water. And I was like, am I really going to go get water? And then I was like, yeah, I should probably go get water. Well, whoever said that, you are a genius. You are the man. And you are correct on everything. So, oh, I have played against them before. Okay. Oh, was that you, Evil Natsu, 1996? Don't watch any clips that just came on here. I was feeling myself a little bit, so I apologize. I was popping off, but I was channeling my inner Mike Ross, so, but definitely good games, sir. Yeah, Starix, it was you. Shout outs to you, man. Good job. But I'm going to take a break. I will be right back, guys. And when we come back, probably about like another hour of online matches, and then we will call it a night for today. So be right back, guys. Going to drink a lot more water. I'm going to start drinking a lot more water. Be right back, guys.